Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. At least one NFL team has come to the conclusion that their money-losing race-baiting nonsense kneelers who ruin entertainment by abusing their platform to protest during work hours could be punished by suspending the players who engage in such pathetic behavior. I'm talking about the players who take a knee to protest, and the Miami Dolphins are about to start punishing people for not having proper anthem conduct. After a horrid 6-10 season last year, the Dolphins probably thought it was the least they could to do bring back fans who boycotted the NFL after a wave of activist millionaires started taking a knee. The only time taking a knee ever meant anything was when Tonya Harding allegedly had someone take Nancy Kerrigan's knee back in 1994. The Dolphins' new policy suggests that any player who protests on the field during the national anthem might face a suspension of up to 4 games. That's quite a few games lost for being a social justice warrior. Hopefully, the players who face this suspension are also losing their paycheck for those weeks. This is quite an improvement for the NFL, as teams with protesting players should always suspend them. It's not their personal time, nor their platform to protest on. These players are at work, and protesting during work hours should always be punishable by the boss. If any of us protested at work, then we would probably be disciplined too, especially if it made our customers turn their backs. Why should it be any different for football players? Miami Dolphins players who protest on the field during the national anthem could be suspended for up to 4 games under a team policy issued this week. Trending: Dems declare war on Michelle Obama after finding red flag she was hiding all along. The proper anthem conduct section is just one sentence in a 9-page discipline document provided to the Associated Press by a person familiar with the policy who insisted on anonymity because the document is not public. It classifies anthem protests under a large list of conduct detrimental to the club, all of which could lead to a paid or unpaid suspension, a fine, or both. Miami's anthem policy comes after the NFL decided in May that teams would be fined if players didn't stand during the Star-Spangled Banner while on the field. The league left it up to teams on how to punish players. None of the team policies have been made public. The NFL rule forbids players from sitting or taking a knee if they are on the field or sidelines during the national anthem, but allows them to stay in the locker room if they wish. The new league rules were challenged this month in a grievance by the players' union. The take a knee nonsense dates back to when Colin Kaepernick was protesting, and we all see how that turned out. He's no longer in the league, and at this point, there's no chance for him to come back. He keeps getting older and likely deteriorating. See what social justice did to him. It cost him his career. What does he do now? Hopefully, he saved some of the money he made while playing. That way he can survive, but he could have been earning millions more for him to spend, donate, or invest. If he's broke, then oh well. Serves him right for dissing the American flag like that. When people abuse their platform in entertainment, then fans are often turned off by it. We watch sports, television programs, and movies as a form of entertainment and escapism. We want to be immersed into a story, drama, and something that's simply there to keep us entertained for an hour or two. As soon as people start protesting during sports, then some people are like, no thanks, and immediately shut it down. People don't like protesters, and they don't like their entertainment ruined. What happens when you combine the two? It's like mixing bleach and ammonia. It's a very bad idea, and it could k**** their careers. We have a few months until the regular season begins for the NFL. That means a lot of teams have plenty of time to get their punishments ready for the disrespectful players. Note from the editor: the views and opinions expressed in this article are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the position of this website or of the owners, administrators of where this article is shared online. Claims are made in this piece are based on the author's own opinion and not stated as evidence of fact.